My research area is the study of power and limitations of computing. In short, it's a study of what computers can do and what computers cannot do. I'm Subhash Khot. I'm a theoretical computer scientist. We would like our computers to do a lot of things for us. And in theoretical terms, these are called designing algorithms to solve computational problems. Over the last several decades, computer scientists have identified a very large class of problems. These are known as NP-complete problems, which they would really like to solve fast. But now they have more or less accepted that these problems cannot be solved fast. Unigame's conjecture, it states that a certain very specific computational problem about coloring nodes of a network to satisfy certain compatibility conditions. And the conjecture states that this problem is very hard to solve, and in fact very hard to even find reasonably approximate solutions. And what the main consequence or the implication of the Unigame's conjecture is that if you believe that this one specific problem is hard to solve, it implies that lots and lots of other problems which computer scientists are very interested in, they are also hard to solve. Unigame's conjecture, it's not yet proven. However, the research surrounding the conjecture, all these efforts, they have actually led to many developments in computer science and mathematics. On the other hand, it's also useful that certain computational problems simply cannot be solved fast. And one such example being factoring integers. For example, if I tell you number 35, and you are supposed to find its factors, say 5 times 7, this cannot be solved fast when the numbers grow really large. And it turns out that the security of almost all online systems, let's say banking, it depends on our belief that nobody knows how to factor integers fast. So Unigame's conjecture, it led to a quite surprising discovery in an entirely unexpected area of research. We know what elections are, and often the result of an election is simply decided by majority vote, right? So if there are two candidates, then whichever candidate gets more votes wins. The Unigame's conjecture, it led to the result that this voting scheme is stable under noise, meaning even if the votes were miscounted, or maybe there was a little bit of noise in recording the votes, it won't really change the winner of the election by much. For several years, I have been trying to make progress on proving the Unigame's conjecture. And in the last 4 or 5 years, me along with my co-authors, we do have quite promising approaches that I'm excited about. I personally have started believing that that we do have actually an approach to prove it. And I'm excited in following these approaches and see where these go.